Secrets, if you really look at yourself, you would be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper?
Activate.
Yo, this is Ludacris.
What's going on? This is Drake.
It's Tiger Young Money Zone.
It's your boy Wiz Khalifa, man.
This is Big Sean.
Yo, what's up, y'all? This is Kanye West.
It's Jay-Z.
Yo, this is your boy Weezy.
You're in the mix
with the DJ always banging the real hip-hop. DJ
BandClap.
You're in the mix with the DJ always banging the real hip hop. DJ
BandClap.
I once played the guitar for over 36 hours straight. I wrote a song about it, like the kid here go.
I love the way you activate your hips and push your ass out. Got a brother wanting it so bad I'm about to pass out. Wanna dig you, and I can't even lie about it, baby. Just alleviate your clothes, I'm the fly about it. Catch you at the club, your hips have got me feeling. Body talking quick to me, but I can't comprehend the meaning. Now if you wanna roll with me, then here's your chance. Doing 80 on the freeway, catch me if you can. Forgive me, I'm a rider, still a rider. Still I'm just a simple man. All I want is money plus the fame. I'm a simple man, Mr. International. Player with a passport, just like Aladdin's wish. Could you anything you ask for? Either him or me. The champagne, Hennessy, favorite of my homies when we floss on our enemies. Witness as we creep to a low speed. Be what my foes need. Make some OGs, funk you don't need. Approaching women with a passion, but a long day. But I've been driven by attraction in a strong way. Your body is banging, baby. I love the way you're flowing. Time to give it to daddy. Sugar, now tell me how you want it.
I said that I could call you whenever I needed someone to listen to me. That's why I'm here standing by your side, cause you always come through for me. So many others tried to be where you are, but they just wanted to do me. But you took your time and now I'm satisfied. That's why I want you all to me.
I said you were my best friend. I want you around all the time.
I want you around me, baby.
Could I be your best friend? I promise, boy, you'll be mine.
Oh, baby, be mine.
I said he's just a friend. Baby, it's not pretend. Either he is or he ain't my man. I said he's just a friend.
Tell me, baby, is it cool to touch? Tell a man that you can trust, not just a fool in lust. Coming to get you on the bus, it's so ironic. Exotic on the verge of erotic. I'm hitting switches on misses like I've been fixed with hydraulics. My up and down like a roller coaster. Can I come inside you? I ain't stopping till the show is over. Cause I'm a rider, in and out just like a robbery. I'll probably be a freaking let you get on top of me.
Why you in your bubble bath? I come washing your back. Why you putting on your lotion? I can help you with that. I sit and think of things to say that may make you smile or give you gifts from the heart to reflect my style. The slang I use when we build may change how you talk. And if I'm focused when I'm stroking, I can change how you walk. It's the swagger that you come with when you come from New York. I'm a hustler, I just hustle in the things that I bought. Separate,
I'm
come
not
on.
Afraid
come
to
on.
Explore my body. Ooh, give me that feeling. And we can watch some TV or play a CD. Maybe that's sexual healing. You try to sing to me, you're never on the key, but you do it just to appease me. I'd rather spend my time wasting time with you. Ooh, you make it so easy. I see you are my best friend. I want you around all the time.
I want you around all the time.
Can I be your best friend? I promise, boy, you'll be mine.
Please, baby, be mine, yeah.
I said he's just a friend.
Oh, oh,
baby, it's not pretend.
No, baby.
Either he is or he ain't my man.
No.
As a youth, to the truth, I got the scoop on how to get a bulletproof. Sex busting off the roof, and when I was a teenager, mobile phones, sky pager, game rules, I'm living major. My adversaries is getting worried, they paranoid, I'm getting buried. One of us gonna see the cemetery, they wonder if my lifestyle's changed. And am I through with all the pain? Surviving in this game, it's still the same. I need to speak me at the strip club, ring a thong. Look how they second for that cash, once again it's on. I had no sympathy for those afraid of mystery. Come get with me, I promise passion and ecstasy. I'm alone, can I come over there tonight? Depend on me, the one to handle it and get it right.
Your body is banging, baby. I love the way you flown. It's time to give it to daddy. Show you the tell me how you want.
I want you around all the time.
I want you around me, baby.
Could I be your best friend? I promise for you be mine.
Oh, baby, be mine.
I said he's just a friend. Baby, it's not pretend. Either he is or he ain't my man. I said he's just a friend. You are my best friend. I want you around all the time.
I want you around me, baby.
Could I be your best friend? I promise for you be mine. Just a friend, baby, it's not pretend. Either he is or he ain't my man.
Yo, yo, what is poppin'? Before the video starts, I just want to let you all know that I give readings, just like the ones that you see every Monday on my channel. I give On Point Orisha Tarot card readings for singles and also for couples. I also do natal chart consultations. My Everything is Everything reading is by far my bestseller. If you want to check out any of these services, please visit my website at www.bandclaptv.com. And also, when you go to that website and you scroll down, you will see a link to go to my shadow work class. In this time that we're in right now, shadow work is very, very important. Getting to know yourself, your inner child, really, really knowing who you are. All of these things are extremely important. And I have a very, very informative self-paced course. Shout out to Spiritual Ascension University and Melanie the Spirit Doula for allowing me to be able to give you all this very, very priceless course, if I do say so myself. So, again, if you want to check these things out, go to my website, www.bandclaptv.com. All right, on with the video. Or I'm not going to say want to. You have a lot of men that are saying this. They are saying this. But the thing about it is, they may not know how to say it in a way where when you're saying this to women, you know, they don't hear certain triggers or feel certain energies to the point where they just feel like you're just bashing women or you hate women or who hurt you and all of this type of stuff. But while I was working, because, you know, I do security at a club. While I was working on this particular day, the energy of Oshun, the baby Oshun, I gotta put that out there. The energy of the baby Oshun was around me all like that whole night while I was working. And this was right at the beginning of cancer season. So this was like the first day of cancer season. The baby Oshun was around me while I was working. And it was like different women who I would have to pat down and look through their bags and stuff like that, because, you know, when you're, no matter what you're doing, especially if you're on a spiritual path and you have to be in a vicinity of people that have different energies and you can feel those energies, you really have to make sure that you're protected spiritually, aura wise and stuff like that, because when you're touching people and you're, you know, stuff like that, people's energy can rub off on you. You know, I know y'all in the chat have went through that in some type of way where you touch somebody, you hug somebody, you kiss somebody, and you just feel their energy on you. And it's an unwanted type of thing. So when I first started on that job, you know, that's what I was going through. You know, I didn't realize how sensitive my hands really were when it came to feeling energy and all of that type of stuff. So that's why I started wearing gloves at work. And shout out to my sister Yvette B, which I'm going to play her ad during this stream. She gave me this aura spray. And when I tell you, I spray that around me before I go to work. And when I come home, And it helps out a lot to seal those cracks and to seal those holes in your aura. And we all need something like that. So I'm patting these women down. I got to make a whole nother stream. I may have to make a whole nother stream just talking about confessions of a club security guard. All the BS that I done went through. What do you think about crystals and gemstones? Do they have metaphysical powers to influence reality? Yes, they do. It's just that you haven't been taught how to harness the energy inside the crystal. So Oshun, she started to speak to me. She was like, this person right here. And she kind of drew up this thing where I can see out of the corner of my eye. And I could see the potential of what this woman could be. And the thing about it is, it was so grand. I'm like, damn, like she can do that. She can do this. She can do this. And then she took it away. And then I saw her for the way she was, how lost she was, or how lost they were. I'm like, damn. Like, I didn't realize, like, at that point. And the thing about it was, this was an ongoing thing. You know, she kept showing me all of these things and all, like, yo, like, you know, she could be the first woman to do this. Like, she could be the one to heal with her hands. Like, she could be the one to, you know, to help this. Like, she could do this, she could do that. And the whole time, like, her energy was, she was so concerned. You know, she was concerned because the way this Maya is going right now. And somebody said this in the chat. They was like, you know, they're not really, it's not a secret. It's not really a secret anymore. Like, it's all out. Like, everything is all out there. And it is so easy because the way we were brought up. You know, a lot of us have ingrown dependency issues, especially when we're talking about women, you know, ingrown dependency issues where, you know, that father may not have been there, or they may not have felt a sense of wholeness as a child, you know, due to different things. And also because a lot of these daughters of Oshun don't have a Yemoya to teach them who they are. So these women have ingrown dependency issues. So what does that mean? You know, even though deep down inside you might have a gut feeling about these people or whatever, at the end of the day, until you learn who you are and know that you are the star, you're looking at everybody else like, yo, like, this is what's popular. So I wanna join up with these other girls. I want to join up with these other girls because this is what's popular. You know, this is what's in, you know. And then they start to kind of live and find solace and find comfortability in that situation. Not realizing that you are who you hang around. And then you start dealing with certain men and then you start to develop all of this baggage, you know, all of these psychological, mental, emotional issues that never go, what's the word? It never go noticed to the point where, you know, you get therapy and stuff like that. Peace, Melanie. Everybody say peace to Melanie, the spirit doula. She is in the building. What is popping? So it's this spiral. But the thing about it is, and this is what Oshun was telling me. She was like, you know, you can take the baddest chick, and it was some baddies that I had to, you know, pat down and let in and all of that. And she was like, look into their eyes, you know, don't focus on the body. Don't focus on that fat ass. Don't focus on them titties. Look at the body. I mean, don't look in her eyes. Look in her eyes. And I was looking in their eyes, and I could tell that individually they were not fulfilled. Individually, they were not fulfilled. But since they don't understand what can fulfill them, since they don't understand since they don't understand what can fulfill them, it's like they're like zombies, you know? Like, you play one, you play Saweetie, or you play Megan Thee Stallion, you play this City Girls, it's like a switch. It's like a switch where it's like every girl do the same move. They do the same little expression with their tongue out. Like, they do the same thing, and it's like a robotic switch. It's like a robotic switch, you know? And it was like, you know, when I was younger, I didn't really pay too much attention to it, because not everybody was like that. But it's like now, especially with these Daughters of Oshun, like I didn't realize that the programming that y'all go through, I didn't realize how powerful and how bad it was, like how bad it really was. And I'm like, man, like, so what is a Daughter of Oshun gonna have to do in order to truly feel fulfilled? To truly feel fulfilled. And so this was while I was in my hotel. So now I'm in my hotel and I'm still feeling this strong Oshun energy, but it's concerned, like this strong energy. So as I'm asleep, I kind of go through this meditative state, and I see this girl, like real cute. She got like this model body, fat ass, but she's kind of like curled up. It's like she's curled up beside me like a baby, like she curled up. And that was a vision of Oshun. It was like a vision, but it was like I was beside her and she was curled up in the bed, like knocked out, like sleep, like a baby. So I'm like, okay, what does this mean? Like, what does this mean? And then it took me back to the stories that I've always been talking about how Oshun, you know, she has this mission. She has this mission to be the Queen Yalorde. But the way you become the Queen Yalorde, it takes a lot of sacrifice. It takes a lot of you thinking about others before you. It takes a lot of you being beautiful, but you got to get your hands dirty. You got to turn that dress from white to yellow in order to get things done. And that's the work that you have to put in to become the Queen Yalorde, you know? But, and then I had the flashback of how, the baby Oshun and the baby Eshu is in the forest. And then she kind of stopped it. She kind of stopped it right there. She was like, this is what made me balanced. She said, this is what made me balanced. This right here. This right here, going into the forest. This is what made, she was like, this is what made me balanced. And being with a baby Eshu is what balanced me out. You know, the Queen Yalorde never forgot about the forest. But a lot of these women today, number one, they don't know anything about the forest. Number two, because of what they've been taught about the forest, they would never get to that point where they're going in the forest just out of curiosity. So three, they'll never understand. And this is something that Oshun told me. She was like, Oshun and Eshu are way more powerful in the forest than they are in the mundane world. They're way more powerful in the forest than they are in the mundane world. So I was like, yo, so, you know, me being the Eshu energy, me being the Eshu Legba type of energy, I understand that wholeheartedly, because when I come out of the forest and I'm in the mundane world, I don't fit in. You know, I'm automatically ostracized. I'm automatically kicked to the side, mainly because my thought patterns and the way I think, the way I put things together, the way I do things, it's because of how the forest is. You know, like in the forest, there is no comfortability. You got to always be moving. You got to always be figuring things out. There's always something new to explore. There's always something new in the forest. You know, in the forest, there is no good and bad. You know, what's popping, Stray Panther? In the forest, there is no good and bad. That same bear that helped you, you know, that helped you in one sense, you go into the forest, that same bear might eat you, you know? So there is no good and bad when we're talking about in the forest. But in this world, in this modern world, we're controlled by duality. So Oshun would never live up to her full potential if she's just in this mundane world. And this is the difference. Because see, I was telling Oshun, I'm like, yo, like when I'm in the forest and I come out into this mundane world, I understand where my power is at. You know, I understand, even though it took me some shadow work, it took me getting to know my inner child, all that. But I understand, you know, with issues, we don't understand that we're powerful at all until we go back to the forest. That's where we understand that we're powerful, because as issues, we don't feel like we're shit, and we're treated like we ain't shit, you know? But see, with Oshun, it's different, you know? Y'all got all of this popularity. Y'all have all of these yes men around y'all, swarming like bees, you know? And then she kind of took me into her life a little bit. You know, you got all these dudes swarming around like bees. They don't really care nothing about you. They just want to smash, you know? You can get anything you want. You can get anything you want in the mundane, but as soon as you have an inkling about something other than the mundane, you start to feel those small bits of being alone, those small little bits, and it makes you run back to the mundane. So what is the forest? What is the forest? So the forest, it represents your subconscious mind. And the forest represents your unconscious mind. You know, your subconscious mind and your unconscious mind. You go into the forest when you meditate. You know, you go into a forest when you go to sleep, you know. But a lot of us, we don't spend a lot of time in the forest. You know, Virgos, SUs, we're known as the hermits. You know, we're the hermits. So we spend a lot of time pondering. We spend a lot of time in deep thought, you know. And this is why we can be very powerful philosophers and all of these different things, because we spend so much time alone in our thoughts, you know. But when it comes to Oshun, she got so many things. Like this mundane world has offered Oshun all of these different things, all of these varieties of different things that you can put your energy into that don't really mean nothing. So at the end of the day, you're unfulfilled until that first day that you go into the forest. And this is what she told me. She was like, when a daughter of Oshun finally goes into the forest, because it happens, but there's not, you know, because of Hollywood, the programming, you know, the things that we've allowed our eyes to see, the things that we've allowed ourselves to experience that will put certain things in your subconscious mind that make you not want to go in there. And you don't and you haven't been taught how powerful your mind really is. You haven't really been taught about it. There's not any books that you learn in school to teach you about your mind and how powerful it is and how you can create these worlds and, you know, all of these different things. Like, you know, you probably been told the mind is all in the universe is mental, but nobody's really explained how powerful that is, you know? So when this daughter of Oshun finally goes into the forest for the first time, Number one, she finds out that everything in the mundane world that she held to such a high standard, it's all a lie. And that can be devastating. It's like you tell a queen, so the kingdom that you've been ruling over, it's all a simulation. Like, it's not really real. You know, you're not really a queen. You're just a part of a simulation. And none of this stuff around you is real. Like, that can be very, very devastating. You know? And this is the reason why baby issues are very important, but we're rare. We're rare because the powers that were try to kill us off, because we're the crossroad. We're the person that you meet at the crossroad that can walk you into the forest, and we can be your tour guide because we've already been there. We damn near live in the forest, you know? So, this is when Oshun finds out how powerful she really is, like how powerful she truly is. Because now, Oshun walking in the forest, like, Alice in Wonderland, you know, she got the birds chirping around her. She got squirrels coming around her. She got big ass lions, and she got crocodiles coming out the ocean just so she can pet them. She got lions, and she got lions crowded around her, you know, all of these things, you know. And then she meets Ayazan, the grandmother. The grandmother Loa, you know, the goddess of the trees and nature and all of this. You know, this is where Oshun learns about Reiki. This is where she learns about herbs and herbal healing and how to speak to trees and how to connect with the fairy kingdom. Like, these are all things that Oshun can do. You know, like, she don't need nobody to teach her how to do that. But, you know, since we forgot who we are, we forgot. My mom actually got a song called "We Forgot." We forgot that we all have these type of powers. So what happens to this daughter of Oshun? She started learning all this information, and now she want to go back around her friends. Now she want to go back around her friends, you know, and stuff like that. Well, it's going to get to a point where everything this daughter of Oshun wants to talk about is going to have something to do with the forest, you know. And her friends that's in this mundane world, they're not going to want to hear about that. They're not going to want to hear about what's going on in the forest, because in their mundane world, the forest is still a scary place. The forest don't mean nothing to them. Like, oh, man, child, here you go again with these tarot cards. Oh, here you go again with this talk, you know. Then it's going to get to the point where, you know, your friends are gonna want to stop kind of hanging around you like that, because once you go into the forest and you find out how powerful you are, you instantly start going on your spiritual journey. That's like the initiation. Going into the forest is the initiation to you going on your spiritual journey, even if you may not know wholeheartedly what that is just yet. So now, you know, this daughter of Oshun and her friends walking around and all of that, all of a sudden, because she got to get this out. So now she making videos. She got a YouTube channel. She talking about all of this stuff about the forest. And she got people coming up to her. Yo, your video changed me so much. I was about to off myself, and I watched your video, and it gave me the strength that I need to keep going. Or, you know, I went through this too. Like, I went through this. I went through that. So I can, you know, I appreciate you for putting this information out, like all of this stuff. So now she's getting a different type of attention, a different type of validation that her friends would never get unless they go into the forest. It's going to get to the point where you're going to start seeing nature, seeing different things that's going to happen before it happened. And, you know, you're going to try to warn your friends. They're going to try to, you know, push it off. And then you end up being right. So now your friends start to look at you as a leader. You know, some of your friends are going to start looking at you as a leader. And if you wasn't that type of person already, this is what's gonna be that final blow. Like, nah, like, you know, you ain't finna outdo me. You ain't finna outshine me. Like, all of this stuff. So this is where it becomes a lonely road. This is where it becomes a lonely road for the baby Oshun. But it's one person that not only was they always there, they was the one that walked them into the forest. They was the one that was happy. You know, she was like, yo, I learned this new spiritual gift. Guess what? I learned this. You know, the baby Oshun was like, ooh, you know. And it ended up being a situation where he's like the last one standing. You know, that's always how it is. But how many of these daughters of Oshun out here have a baby Oshun that can do that for them? You know, someone who looks at them as something more than something that you're just gonna smash or whatever. But it's on a high spiritual level type of situation. So with that being said, just like I said in my last video when I was talking about the celebrities, just because you don't know who you are, don't mean that this system of soulless beings don't know who you are and they don't know how to harness your energy. You know, they don't know how to harness your energy. So it's like now, if you really want to be on this spiritual path, like if you really want to be on this journey, there's so much that you're going to have to let go. This comes into the second thing that I kind of want to talk about. Especially after seeing what I saw in these clips about the BET Awards. And I said this, I think, on my birthday when I was like, I know that a lot of us are still programmed. You don't see yourself as nothing else but a black man. You don't see yourself as nothing else but a black woman, stuff like that. You can say all black men, all black women are like that until your face turns blue. But when you name yourself something that's a part of a community, put write community down, because that's going to come back later. When you're a part of a community, you know, when that name represents a community, that means that everything that's on the back, everything wrong and everything right falls on you. Everything wrong and everything right falls on you, whether you want it to or not. So when I saw Taraji P welcome out the City Girls and she was like, shake your asses, everybody, let's shake our asses. And you got and shout out to Angry Man. I got to shout out Angry Man because he was the first one to talk about this last night. You got kids. You got little kids in the audience. You know, you got older well-to-do people in the audience, you know, and you got this woman old that's supposed to be an elder talking about let's all shake our asses, you know, and then you see the music. Now I didn't watch the award show, but I seen a few little clips of it. And then you see that. So you as a woman that's at home. You know, you might have a wholesome family. You know, you might be a good person. And you say, well, I'm not like that. I am not like that. But when society as a whole look at black women, this is what they see. You know, this is what they see. There wasn't any representations of the wholesome black woman that's at home, the wholesome black woman that dresses very nice. You know, she's not showing anything, but she's classy, she's elegant, you know. Those representations aren't shown in mass more than the Megan Thee Stallions of the world, the City Girls of the world, the Young Miamis of the world, the Lil Nas X's of the world, you know. So now I'm about to put a second thing on it. Because 2 years ago on my birthday, I said that it's gonna be when you're learning who you are and all of this stuff, it's gonna be hard trying to identify yourself still with being a black person, my black woman, black man. Because what y'all have to realize is for a couple hundred years or whatever, it's been a while since being black is just associated with a color. It's been a long, long while. It's been a long time since the word black is just a color, you know? And Kanye West talked about this when he was talking about classism, because that's what I'm talking about, classism. You know, who are the insurgents? Who are the divergents? And who are the everyone else? You know? So it's kind of like, you know, you're going about your everyday life. And this actually happened to somebody. And then you do a DNA test or something and you find out that you're like a long lost heir to a royal throne in Tanzania or in Africa or something. And you do this DNA test and this royal family wants to bring you in so you can rule, so you can step into your power. But you got to give up your American citizenship. You can still come to America like on a visa, like something like that. But if you come over here, you got to give up your American citizenship. This is what we're going to, and I'm not saying this is going to happen today, this year, next year. I don't know how long it's going to take. But Erykah Badu, she had a point when she said, if we are made in his image, then call us by our names. When you learn who you are, when you know who you are and you know your lineage, you know your soul family, all of these things, and you get on this spiritual path, this spiritual journey, and then you want to double back and do things for the community, the communita, you know, because you're still holding on to this programming that you're still a black man, that you're still a black woman. So that means you need to have this standard. You need to do this. You need to do that. That's about to be the equivalent of you serving two masters. And we all know what the Bible says. You can't serve two masters. You can't be on this path, you know, and spirit is telling you to do this and do that. And you're like, no, I can't do that because it's going to make me look bad as a black man. Or it's going to, I can't, hold on. I can't do this. I can't say this because I'm going to feel like I'm letting my black community down. You know? It's about to become a time. It's about to become a time to where you're really going to have to step away from, now I'm not saying like on paper, like when you're filling out an application or something like that, you don't put black, but I'm just saying like being involved with these shenanigans and associating yourself with that just because you want to stay down with the community and all of that. In these new times, in these times that are coming, as you can see, that's going to be very contradictory. It's going to be very, very contradictory. So going back to what I was saying about the hotel dream, going back to that, that's the only way that you're going to truly be protected, because now we're talking about relationships. We're talking about, because as you can see in this triangle, right? Or as you can see in this, image, that's in front of you, you got the Libra sign. And you also have the Aquarius sign. And we know that Aquarius, that's the age that we're in. And then Libra, that represents relationships, you know? So new age relationships. The new age relationships that's being put in front of you are Megan Thee Stallion and Young Miami kissing. That's the new age relationship that they're putting out there on black entertainment television, aka black exploitation television. That's the type of relationships that they're pushing. You know, Lil Nas X, I heard that it was two men that was kissing too. Now, when it comes to the LGBT community, I have nothing, this is not a shot at the LGBT community, but with that being said, I feel like even the LGBT community, even them, they should be outraged by the fact that you still got people out here who are straight, but when they go to different shows and they enter different societies and when they get into different things, they're only gay for pay. They're only gay for pay. You know, that should offend you. If you was if you're in the LGBT community and you got a straight person, you got straight people representing you and they're really gay for pay, you know, that should offend you. You know, but I'm not a part of that community, so I don't really know. And when you look at the music, when you look at the music and the media manipulation that's out right now, you can tell me in the chat if these things really, really promote wholesome and positive relationships in the Aquarian age. Wholesome and positive relationships in the Aquarian age. And y'all can let me know, you know, because maybe I might be tripping. But from what I've seen and what I see, it's all about separation. It's all about separation. Why would Taraji P. Henson have to say, black men, we need y'all back, like we left and went somewhere? Why would she have to say, we need y'all back? We need you. We need, most of all, we need you. You know, we love you. You know, y'all are kings. And most of all, we need you. Why would she have to say that? You know, like we just went somewhere. Unless there was a societal system that was put in place by people like Taraji P. Henson, by people like Megan Thee Stallion, by people like the City Girls, by people like Cardi B, to make black men not want to deal with black women anymore. You know? And I'm going to talk about Red Pill too. Because that was the next thing I was going to talk about. And as a black woman, you can say all day long, oh, that ain't me. That's not me. All women aren't like that. We're all not like that. But like I said, if you call yourself a name that represents an entire community, good or bad, whatever good or bad that community does, it's all going to come on you because you call yourself that name. You know, I call myself Eshu Legba. I understand the good and bad that comes with calling with that comes with that energy. But it's already me. It's already me. You know? So at least I can control me. I can control me. I can't control the whole community. That's why I came up with my own stuff. The baby Eshu. You know, the baby issue. I came up with my own stuff, you know, and we're all unique like that. The soul family are a bunch of unique individuals who know who they are. They're walking on their own separate paths, but we all have a common goal, you know, that common goal of purity, of righteousness, you know, of innocence. And what's up, y'all? I hope y'all enjoyed that video. And if you stayed to the end, I appreciate you. Also, if you haven't already, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, I want to redirect you to my Instagram page. I don't promote my Instagram page a lot, but as my subscriber count and things like that rise due to things like shadow banning and stuff like that, I'm hearing that a lot of people aren't getting my notifications when I go live on YouTube and stuff like that. So for all things BandClap TV, my Instagram page and my story are going to have all of the notifications and things like that when it comes to when I'm going live, when I'm going, you know, when I'm releasing videos, when I'm releasing content. Also on my Instagram page, if you're curious about my reviews for my readings and stuff like that, as you can see on my Instagram, I have a lot of different testimonials and stuff like that. For those who don't know of me as an artist, I also have videos of me performing and stuff like that. I'll be putting out more stuff like that very, very soon. So I'm just trying to get as many people right now to go ahead and follow me on Instagram. That is BandClap TV. And also my Facebook and Snapchat, BandClap TV as well. All right, y'all. I appreciate y'all. And like I always say, no matter what, you got to stay shining.